Hello, g4 knight of 6 c4 e6 knight c3 bishop e4 g3 d5 knight f3 castles bishop g2 dc castles knight c6 a3. So we opt for bishop e7. And now white should play e4. Otherwise, black is just bad. Black has extra pawn. For example, queen a4, we take on d4, rook d1, knight f3. Bishop f3, bishop d7, queen c4, and c6. Just with extra pawn, or bishop g5, knight a5, knight e5, and knight d7, bishop e7, queen e7, like was one correspondence game, and black is pawn up. e3 now it's a bad idea because knight a5, now knight e5, then black has knight d7. So now you understand why. In the previous video, white tried to play bishop to g5 and bishop f6, because now always knight e5 is countered with knight d7. If f4, then c5. If queen e2, then knight e5, d, and queen d3, and black is better. Queen e2, rook b8, we know the idea to play b5. If now rook d1, then b5, e4, knight b3, it's a good idea to take this bishop, rook b1, knight c1, rook bc1, and c6. When black was better, and Perelstein again, Charbonneau game. If now knight e5, then just b5, because black is pawn up. Morande against Movsesyan game. a4, now. Black plays knight d5, bringing another knight to defend the pawn. If e4, then knight b4 with the deal point, knight d3. If bishop d2, then b6, knight e5, and bishop to b7. And I don't see how to win this pawn back. So black is better. So the critical line is e4. Now black plays knight a5. In this line we opt for knight a5 instead of rook b8, because in the lines where pawn was a2, then on e5 before was the idea. Now white has no before idea, so it's our main setup, knight a5. And the best move is bishop e3. If queen e2, then a6. The deal plan b5, for example, rook d1, knight b3, rook a2, b5. Or bishop e3, it's a transposition. Bishop f4, b5, rook a d1, bishop b7, h4, knight b3. If a4, then c6. If bishop g5, h6, bishop f4, rook e8, rook f1, and bishop f8, Hauke's against Lenderman, and black is better. Now, two moves with the bishop, bishop e3 and bishop f4. What's the difference? The difference in the line, bishop f4, we play a6, queen c2 is the best move, b5, rook a d1, c6, and d5. If h4, h6, knight e5, bishop b7, g4, knight b3, bishop e3, that is the problem. I should protect this pawn. And knight d7, black was much better in the game post in Markidis. So d5, it's our sorry, it is white's best try, but in that case, cd, ed, knight d5, knight d5, ed, knight g5, bishop g5, and rook d5. And we will see the same position with the bishop on e3. And I think that in that case, the position is equal. But now, queen b6. And after rook g5, bishop b7, and black is better. So, bishop e3, a6, and the best move is queen c2. Because queen e2 has the problem that queen is misplaced there. b5, rook a d1, bishop b7. And now if d5, then it takes d5, and if it is a rook e8, and that's the problem. The queen is misplaced. And if e5, knight e8, e6, Then just c6 protecting the pawn. Ef, rook f7, knight f5, rook f5, bishop d4, bishop d6, bishop h3, and rook f6. That was a correspondence game, and black has serious advantage. If bishop f4, so I don't like bishop e3, then playing bishop f4. Lee against Kachkov game here. Black should have played knight b3, attacking the pawn. If rook f1, then rook e8, a4, b4 is advantage. If a4, b4, d5, bc, dc, queen e8, engine likes that line for white for a bit, but after ef7, rook f7, queen c4, knight c5, knight g5, cb, rook b1, knight fe4, queen f7, queen f7, knight f7, queen f7, rook b2, and bishop d5, he finally understands that black has more active pieces, so white is in trouble. If h4, then just c5. So the problem is that white loses a pawn. If d5, ed, knight d5, knight d5, ed, then just bishop d6, and black is much better. If dc, queen e8, bishop d6, then just knight c5, and black has healthy extra pawn. If d5 immediately, then ed. Of course, ed, bishop d6, black is better. If knight d5, knight d5, ed, then the problem is that rook e8 and black is better. And if e5, then just knight h5, and white should spend the tempo on bishop e3, but then g6, and black safeguards the h5 knight. Knight d2, knight d2, rook d2, c6, f4, knight g7, queen f2, f5, black stabilizes the position. Black is 2 pawns up, black is close to winning. If knight g5, now then h6, h4, knight b3, e5, bishop g2, king g2, knight d5, so white is in trouble. Maybe the best try is knight e5 now, but queen e8. Now bishop g5, then rook d8, knight g4, knight g4, queen g4, bishop g5, queen g5, knight b3, queen e5, rook d7, bishop h3, queen e7. Rook f1 and just queen d6, slowly improving the position. Queen h5, rook d8, that was counter against Belyavsky game. Black was much better. If knight g4, then just knight b3. The best chance for white is f4. I faced sometimes this line, and white's idea is to play g4, g5, a5, and so on, but I really don't believe in white's position. For example, rook d8. G4, knight b3, g5, knight d7, h4, just take on e5, king h8, bishop h3, bishop c8, and I don't see how white can process the attack, and black's idea is just to play c5. So queen c2 is better, because queen is not misplaced on c2. Black plays b5 and rook ad1. White can start with d5, ad, rook ad1. It doesn't really matter. We play c6 and d5, because now if knight e5, bishop b7, then it's easy play for black. g4, knight b3, f4, queen c7, g5, knight d7, knight d7, queen d7, e5, and rook a8. And black wants to play queen c7, then c5, and so on. So don't believe in white's attack. That was a game between two engines. If queen e2, I don't understand this move, just bishop b7, what is better, so d5. Ed, ed, knight d5, knight d5, cd, knight g5, bishop g5, and rook d5, everything is forced. And remember, I told that we had the position with the bishop on f4, and queen b6 was a good move. Now black cannot play queen b6, black plays queen c7, and white has important intermediate move, rook c5, because if rook g5, then bishop 7, rook h5, and g6, and black has extra pawn, so rook c5, queen e7, rook g5, bishop b7, rook h5. And the problem is that after g6, bishop c5, that was a game shot against the bashes, black should sacrifice the exchange. So I think that black should play f5 instead, and the position is balanced. Bishop b7, knight b7, rook f5, rook f5, queen f5, rook d8, h4, or bishop g5, queen d7. And black is slightly better in the endgame because black has pawn advantage on the queen side. So h4 is better, but then queen f7, and I think this position is balanced. But it's playable position. So let's make some conclusions. Well, after a3 we go bishop e7, and after e4 we play knight a5. The difference is that the pawn is on a3. So white's knight, black's knight is has a good square a5. And I think if white doesn't know the main line, with playing queen c2 at some point, then going for very fast d5, everything is forced. Okay, in that line white has an equal position, otherwise white has some problems. So let's make some conclusion about this line in general. So I think that we saw that after bishop g2 dc, if white castles, it's really not obvious compensation for white. Maybe white should opt for a3 with an equal position instead. But you should be prepared with both covers, because if you don't know what to do with black, then it's a complex position, and white could have a good game. But now you saw my lines, and I think that you are well prepared to the Nemtsov-Katavan hybrid line. So thanks for watching these videos, and see you again soon. Goodbye.